I've been lucky enough in a couple of films to work with great filmmakers, and those have been, you know, the highlights of my my acting experiences. You know, Saving Private Ryan with Steven Spielberg, that really will always be the high mark in my career. But for the most part, I do prefer to work in my own films as an actor. It probably has to do with this style of filmmaking that I have honed over the course of, you know, 15 or 17 years, whatever it's been, in that, you know, I love to collaborate with my cast. And I love to allow them to improvise and not have to stay on book the entire time. And I like that as an actor. So when I'm the writer, director, and actor in my own films, not only do I encourage them to do that when I'm not in a scene, but when I'm in a scene with them, I like to play around with them to see what can I pull out of this actor that might be different or they might not expect while I'm actually acting in a scene with them.
And what triggered you to write this script? Your middle name is Fitzgerald, yeah. Right? Is this about your family, Christmas?
It isn't about my family, but you know, it is probably my most personal film to date. There's none of the major plot points from my family. Like, my dad is a great guy, didn't abandon the family. I only have 3 siblings and not 7. But there are a number of smaller moments and conversations that I pulled directly from my life. There's a scene where I take the youngest brother, Tom Guyrie, we're in Manhattan, and I show him the old tenement in Hell's Kitchen where our family came from. While I was writing the screenplay, I had that exact conversation with my mom. And she was telling me about their tenement. And I was like, all right, I want to pull that sense of, you know, this family's history into the screenplay. So there are little moments like that throughout the film. And then, you know, in this film, it's Rosie Fitzgerald. My grandmother was Josie Fitzgerald. And her husband was a terrible human being, my grandfather. And I'd say the dad in this is sort of some version of him. So part of the reason that I wanted to set it at Christmas is one of those times where, you know, your family gets together, you're under one roof, usually for a day or two, and a lot of things come up, you know, the good and the bad. You're gonna make the big announcement like, all right, I'm going to propose to my girlfriend, or we're having a baby, or guess what, we're getting divorced. So I thought, given that I have 7 siblings and I'm going to pack a lot of story into this, I thought Christmas was the right time of year where all of those things could happen and it could still remain plausible. But then also, you know, those themes of Christmas about family and forgiveness was a big part of what I was trying to do.